Hello, everyone. In this video, we are going to take a look at the frequency response analyzer function of the latest FNIRSi DPOS350P tablet oscilloscope. In analog electronics, the frequency response of circuits and its measurement has always played an important role. Here you can see the circuit diagram of a frequency-dependent Wien divider drawn with microcap 12. And this is a small board prepared for 10th grade students so that the circuit can be measured more easily. This will be one of the frequency-dependent circuits that we'll use in this video. Now, here is another circuit diagram. This one was made with LT Spice, and it shows a bridge twin T filter. Of course, I quickly built a protoboard version of this one too, so that we can measure it as well. With a sweepable generator and an oscilloscope, we can already plot the behavior between the two extreme frequencies, either linearly or even logarithmically. Here is the result of such a measurement. The output amplitude of the Wien divider as a function of frequency. At the frequency determined by the RC elements, the output is 1/3 of the input signal. At all other frequencies, it decreases as we move further away in either direction. This next figure shows the output of the bridge twin T filter. At the frequency defined by the RC elements, we get a clear amplitude minimum. As we move away from this point in both directions, the amplitude increases again. With this simple measurement, however, we gain no information about the phase response of the circuit, and we don't get numerical data for the amplitude either. Therefore, if we want more detailed data, we have to determine them by point-by-point measurements. That is why it was such a big step forward for me when I acquired these two Siglent devices, an oscilloscope and a function generator capable of working together with it. With these two instruments, it became possible to conveniently record the frequency response of the previous two circuits. Here you can see the frequency response of the Wien divider, and here is the frequency response of the bridge twin T filter. So I was able to easily record the frequency response of circuits, but for this I had to use two instruments, and I also had to connect them with USB or Ethernet. This is why my attention was immediately caught by the latest FNIRSi DPOS350P tablet oscilloscope. Not only does it include a built-in generator up to 50 MHz, but with its built-in frequency response analyzer function, it can also record Bode diagrams. So I ordered one right away from the company's Spanish web shop, where it was available at a good price and arrived quickly. I was very curious when I unpacked it, and most of all, I was interested in this very function. At that time, I only had the small Wien divider panel available, so I started my tests with it. First, with 20 measurement points, this was the result. This already happened after I installed the latest firmware update, which extended the lower frequency limit from 100 Hz down to 10 Hz. But as you can see in the figure, the software adaptation doesn't really work properly below 100 Hz. Most likely, it was no coincidence that the earlier limit had been set to 100 Hz. It was only those working with audio frequency measurements who requested lowering it at least to 20 Hz. With the maximum number of points increased to 500, the instrument drew this picture. And since it doesn't do any averaging at all, each measurement produces slightly different results. Sometimes, especially the phase, shows incredible fluctuations. Here you can see the bridge twin T filter from 100 Hz up to 100 kHz with 20 measurement points. I chose this range because the software only provides the usual logarithmic frequency axis when three full decades are covered. Now the same circuit again, but this time with 500 points up to 10 kHz. Since this is only two decades, we get rather exotic labels on the frequency axis. And again, the phase shows huge variations. But still, you can clearly see that at the null frequency, the phase drops from maximum down to minimum. And here lies the problem, which is why I made this video. The Siglent instruments show exactly the opposite. At the null frequency, the phase sharply changes from minimum up to maximum. The same can be seen in the microcap 12 simulation, and the LT Spice simulation also shows the same behavior. So we can say that in the FNIRSi DPOS350P's frequency response analyzer function, the absolute value of the phase, apart from the fluctuations caused by lack of averaging, is correct, but its sign is opposite to reality. Of course, the same phenomenon appears with the Wien divider as well. Here is the FNIRSi diagram, where the phase continuously increases, while the MicroCap12 AC simulation output shows a continuous decrease. And the LT-SPICE AC analysis of the Wien divider shows the same decreasing phase. So anyone who wants to use this otherwise very useful little instrument to measure frequency responses needs to be aware of this fact. Hopefully, FNIRSi will correct it in a future firmware update. At least I really hope so, because in its current state, it is not so convenient for use in education. Thank you for watching this video. I hope this was useful. If you liked the video, please give it a like, because it always makes me happy and motivates me to create more videos. If you enjoy this kind of technical content and you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, now is the perfect time to do so. And to my subscribers, thank you for your trust. I'll keep working on interesting topics. Until then, if you haven't seen them yet, you can check out my earlier videos as well. So, see you next time, or in one of my previous videos.